Hello, my name is Peter Boxall, and it's a pleasure to be saying a few words of introduction about my book with John Purcell, Strategy and Human Resource Management, published by Palgrave. What's the fundamental purpose of the book? The purpose of the book is to integrate the fields of human resource management and strategic management in order to develop a thorough review and integration of the field of strategic human resource management. A key thing about the book is that we take an analytical approach to this task. That means that we're intent on understanding what managers do, why they do it in human resource management, how they go about it, and who benefits from human resource management. This is an analytical approach in terms of being thoroughly based in empirical research and in theory. And it's only on the basis of engaging with research and theory that we then subsequently enter into prescriptions or policy advice. How is the book structured or designed? After we spend the first two chapters discussing fundamental definitions and concepts in human resource management and strategic management, the book is fundamentally structured around a set of chapters on the general principles of strategic HRM, and there's a number of key things in there that we want readers to engage with. And then it has four chapters that are on the specific contexts of human resource strategy. And there we look in depth at manufacturing, at services, at multi-divisional firms, and at multinational firms, before a final chapter brings it all together in terms of our key themes and talks about what next for the practitioner. Something I must point out to you all is that this is not a book designed for first year or second year or any entry level students in human resource management. This is a book for third and fourth year students or for MBA students in general management programs. It's for people who've already got some introduction to organizational behavior or human resource management or employment relations within the context of their specific country or national system of employment relations. This is an advanced book, which presupposes that people who are interested in the HR practices that are around in their own specific country will have tackled that through an introductory textbook that's relevant to their country. I should also point out that the revision from the third to now the fourth edition is very substantial, much more so than the revision that took place from the second to the third. You'll see that every chapter is affected by the revision. The theory, the research, the case studies, the websites, everything is completely updated. And you will see in terms of the structure that it's now much more apparent how we deal with the mega contexts of manufacturing and services. And we've split multinational firms from multi-divisional firms with a chapter on each. Finally, I want to point out that there is a companion website and there is a case study there, including case studies that are revised and new ones for every chapter in the book. There are slides for every chapter in the book, and there are essay questions. We are committed to continuing to improve the teaching resources that are available to you. Thank you very much.